Welcome everyone to HFN, also known as HueFin News. What's going on, trap watchers? Today is the last day of July 2021. We're going to give you all a price prediction update in the market for GameStop. Yes, you can see from our chart already, we got a price prediction already ongoing. We played the weakness into the market in GameStop. Now we just want to simply see, can we still get a short squeeze out the market in GameStop? Because one thing I will tell you is that the price in GameStop has been maintaining itself a lot better than AMC, right? The volatility in AMC is a lot stronger than what we're getting in the GameStop. Now that would translate over into, yeah, there's a lot of market participation going on in GameStop, right? So that's one reason why we really haven't been too bearish or too weak in terms of where we're expecting this price to go, right? So I'm going to give you all the update in the market in GameStop, because one thing that we do, we make sure that we get in position so that we can capitalize on price movement. And that's the only thing that matters, is the price, right? That's why we only speak on the price and where it's going to go. I don't care about what dark pools are doing. I don't care about short interest, shares available to borrow. I don't care about GameStop earnings reports. I don't care about technical indicators, because it only causes you more confusion. But so many people call that due diligence, and you end up being more confused than you are justifying where price is going to go off of that information. So if you guys want to join us, again, the doors are open. Hit the like button, share, and also subscribe to the channel. Because one thing we will not do is we will not hype these stocks. We will not pump these stocks. We will not tell you that everything is a freaking buy, because that is not the case. Stocks do go down in value too. You need to have somebody in your corner willing to tell you that, hey, yeah, you might be seeing a lot of videos out there talking about this stock is a buy and buy it on the dips and it's going to go here, it's going to go there. But then the market goes down. We're those people. We'll let you know if the price is anticipated to go lower, because price is what it is. You can't change it. I can't change it. The only thing we can do is to get in the position and grab the bag. That's what we're all about. So hit us up if you guys want to join. All right, so check this out. Last time we did our price prediction in GameStop was actually on July the 17th, and this has been what has occurred, excuse me, in the market in GameStop since that time. We were already in position expecting the market price in GameStop to go lower. Now, initially, from the gate, yeah, the price in GameStop did go higher, right? That's why we told everyone in our community is that we're still going to play the weakness into the market in GameStop so long as that price does not break above, you know, $197, $200. And so far, that maintained itself. So it lets me know that the weakness in GameStop is still on the table. Nothing has changed since our last price prediction video on July the 16th. You can still check it out. It's in our GameStop playlist. We're not hiding anything from our people. We want to make sure that you also learn from what we talk about on these charts, because it's simple. Everyone else is just making it confusing and complicated. So one thing I will do though, is I'm seeing market in GameStop actually trying to hold this area as restriction. So right now the price in GameStop is trading within this range, right? $200, maybe even $220 could be that area of restriction in GameStop. So let me switch this over to the 3-day. Okay, so you can see it here that the price in GameStop, I will say, yeah, I'm bringing it down here to around $200. Right, so that still stands. If the price in GameStop cannot break above $200, we're going to continue at best continue to trade within these two lines on my chart, or next price will go down, period. Okay, you're not going to hear people give you this information because their value about the clicks and the subscribers, and they just want you to increase their ad revenue rather than trying to help you out into reading and what the price means, right? Next thing, I want you all to see this too, okay? Could this be where the price in GameStop is trying to go? Because you can see that this is where the trend is. So are we trying to see the market move price here? I'm gonna circle it for you. Is the market price in GameStop trying to go there? For real, like, you gotta get in position, you gotta expect these things, because if so, this is prime real estate right here to buy GameStop. Right there around $125 to $135. That's prime real estate because it confirms that price in GameStop is going to continue on the trend, and you bought it at a cheaper price than what it is right now. That's prime real estate. That's the bullseye right there. So, and that's only under the premise that we get strength on this trend though. If we don't get any strength on this ascending line, then this is not a buy. The market's going to continue to go lower in price in GameStop. So this is where we need to be on the lookout for. I mean, the trap could literally be in the market trying to bring this price down here before the market will go higher. I'm just saying, you got to plan these things out. You got to be prepared for these price movements. All right, so keep your eyes open on that $135 to $125 price level for GameStop. Now, we've ended out the month of July. Today is the last day of the month. So let me show you all what's going on the monthly time frame in GameStop. Okay, so take a look. Do you see any strength here into the market in GameStop? This is on a monthly basis. Every price bar you see on this chart is a month worth of price movement. And do you see any strength for the month of July? I want to tell you, charts don't lie. Everyone else tries to deceive you. Price never gives you any lies. It always shows you the truth about where it's trying to go. So we've had weakness enter the month of June, and the weakness continue on into the month of July. What about on a 3 weeks time frame? This is a 3 weeks time frame. We're still in a downtrend in GameStop. Why will people still try to convince you that this market is going to go higher in price? When in fact, the last 9 weeks, nine consecutive weeks, the market price in GameStop has closed lower than the previous one. Again, $135, $125. How do we end out on the week? This is the weekly time frame. So again, all in all, the weakness is still here in GameStop, right? It is. We're still expecting the price in GameStop to go lower. Now, again, take a look at where we're expecting the support to come in at, though. $135, $137, $135. I want you all to see this here, too, though, okay? Because $150 would also be a place to where we would take out the profit into this play. $150, because I can see that here. I'm gonna show it to you that the market support can also come in here. Okay, so yeah, I will skim off some profits around $150 too. So those are the two areas that we would come through and TP out the bag, take the loot from the trap. You see that money he got in his briefcase, right down in the bottom left side of my screen? That's our money. We need to try to get it back. Just plain and simple. This is how you're able to beat everyone else in the market. You don't beat these hedge funds by holding stock. That's pretty much what they want you to do. Because when you hold a stock, you actually are able to tell where the market is, where the market is headed. And if you continue to lower the price, would you hold it all the way to zero? Because you got some people out there that's willing to hold these stocks all the way to zero, even when the chart is a screaming sell, even when the chart is telling that there's no life in it and that price is going to continue to go lower, people will still hold because they're under the premonition that the market is all about a war and you're trying to take out hedge funds and you're trying to take out this person and that person, when in the grand scheme of things, it's only about making money, period. And once you start instituting some other things outside of that reason, you begin to lose the whole purpose of why the markets are created. And you begin to lose sight, and you will end up losing because you are losing the grand scheme of why we create these markets, why these markets even exist. And it's only to make money, right? So now, we're not going to change our price prediction. We're still going to expect the price in GameStop to go lower. All right, first area for us to grab some bag, grab some money, will be around $1.50, all the way back down here to $1.35. That's it. All right, so now, right now, do you think the short squeeze is going to happen? Not yet. I still think the price and GameStop have some lower movement to go through, namely 150, 135, and then from there we might get a bounce or move higher. That's it. Now let me know, what do you all think about GameStop? Where do you think the price is going to go? Give us your price prediction, right? Tell me, where do you think the price in GameStop is headed over the next 3 weeks? In 3 weeks, where do you think the price will be? Because it doesn't matter what I think. It doesn't matter what anyone thinks. What do you think? Drop me a comment. Make sure you maintain a profitability. And as always, trade different.